जैनिज्म ऑल्सो देर आर सो मेनी थिंग्स लाइक यू नो महावीर भगवान का पिछला लाइक तीर्थंकर्स ऑल्सो दे से उसका अवतार है लाइक यू नो दे से दैट बुद्धिज्म जातका टेल्स यू ऑल नो एंड बुद्धा हिमसेल्फ इज अवतार ऑफ भगवान वे टेल बुद्धा एंड कल्कि यू नो दे आर वन ऑफ द लास्ट अवतार सो बेसिकली हिंदुइज्म इज ऑल अबाउट इंकार्नेशंस एंड री इंकार्नेशंस एंड ऑल दैट इन फैक्ट इफ यू टेक जैनिज्म बुद्धिज्म एंड इवन आर Sikhism, these are all the offshoots of Hinduism, I would say. Because I don't know, spirituality I like a lot. I've read a lot of books and all. Bhagavad Gita almost I have read all versions. Read from Mahatma Gandhi, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, then I have read there are certain things in Kannada literature. So everywhere you see different, and even Guru Granth Sahib I read. Guru Granth Sahib reflects everything about what is written in Gita. You know, it is, and even Kabir ka dohas you take it. The essence and philosophy is Veda and Gita only. So that is how it has happened. So actually what we do, you know, whenever... Pachi Madhoshi. Actually what happens is like, you know, when the mind is always critical, whether we admit it or not, the minute we see somebody who start our assessment begins. Oh, this fellow is looking like this. He may be skeptical, or he may be a cunning fellow, or he may be a good fellow. Because how we make these assumptions based on our past experience. Suppose this pretty girl who is sitting there, if her face resembles then that of my mother-in-law, first sight I will say, oh, she's not a pretty girl, and she is very wicked. I know it. Like, you know. Why? Because your equation with somebody, this person may be a completely a very good human being and very supportive, very loving. And if your equations are not there, okay, like she is like that. And you know, we start forming opinions and all that. And also we get judgmental very fast by the way people dress, by the way people talk, by the way people sit. And always there is one element of doubt. See, this is called as rational mind. Now, when we take, get you into hypnosis. Now, when you come into hypnosis, what happens is, your rational mind is kept aside for some time. You are made entirely to relax the entire body so that rationality is taken away. So you start focusing on the moment. When you start focusing on the moment, whatever you want, you can achieve. This is your famous secret book. Nothing else, nothing great about it. This has been told in our Vedas and all that long back. You know, today all these people are telling secret, oh no, Proctor has told like this and that, everybody quotes and it's nothing big, everything is already told by our people. So once the rational mind is shut aside, then you try to focus and you can achieve anything. But there are a lot of fears about this kind of thing. You know, people when they come, first session is I need to take them and talk about what it is and what it is not. People feel if you hypnotize a person, you can make them do anything. It is not true. It is a street hypnosis or mass hypnosis just for a particular purpose, like 1 or 2 seconds or 30 seconds or 1 minute it might last and it has no meaning. Okay? But actually even when you are taken in, even during the past life regression, you are completely aware of what is happening. Any given point of time you say you don't want to continue it, you come out of it. And also you will get into that mode and start seeing your past life only if you believe and only if you are open minded. If you are 100% sure, I am not going to do it, right? It's not going to happen, it will never happen. See, I'll tell you, like, you know, you must have heard the phrase, faith can move mountains. Do you know a story behind that?
No.
No? Okay. There was one lady, old lady, who was very Catholic lady, very fond of prayers, and she used to say, you know, if you pray, everything happens, and this and that. That lady had a house, and she was staying on the second floor or whatever, and her window was facing the east direction. Every day day she longed to see a sunrise, but there was a huge mountain. So then she one day said, okay, I trust so much and I get so many things in the, whenever I pray, I have been able to achieve. Then why do I not pray and go this mountain? So she closed her eyes, she tried to pray. I want this mountain to be moved, I want this mountain to be moved, I want to see the sunrise and all that. Then after some time, she opened the things and said, God, this mountain is not moved. Then she said, I knew it wouldn't move. Half the time we do this in life. We try to show a lot of faith in other person, at the basic level we don't trust. So anything in life, what you want to achieve, the first thing is open-mindedness and trust. If you trust, something will work. If you don't trust, it won't work. It's as simple as that. Okay. So I believe in this past life regression. Definitely it helps. But again, I'm telling, it should not be a matter of joke, just to find out. Or, you may be having some relation problems with your... relation doesn't necessarily mean mother-in-law and daughter-in-law. It could be between a husband and wife, it could be between a father and a daughter, or mother and a daughter, any kind of, or even your best friend, or your own children, anywhere. Like, if you feel that there is a problem which cannot be really analyzed at a reasonable level, when you are in a rational level, then there is something to it. Relationship problems and phobias are there, physical problems and fears of some kind. And, some people I have seen, there was one person, he would do everything and his focus was on making a lot of money, But he would do everything, but in the last minute something would go wrong and that thing would go flop. And when it was taken, it is again a psychological problem also, why such a thing happens and all that. That is a fear of failure, okay? So there are few people who invest their energy and time to this extent. When it is going to come, the fructification comes, then there is an emergent moment. At that point, they give up. They say, hell with it. Enough is enough. Then there is a plateau coming or you don't progress. Psychologically, this is a thing. So that can also be correlated to some past life problems wherein you must have had a severe setback which you are not able to forget even after different centuries. If you have any query, you ask her, we want to talk.
Are there people who cannot be hypnotized at all, no matter how much they want to be?
No. See, anybody, how much they want to be, they cannot be hypnotized means, I don't believe in that statement at all. It means at the grassroots level, a person is not wanting it. There is not a single person who cannot be hypnotized. But if you come with a skeptical mind that, I don't believe in